joined Kurdistan with two other provinces and a new country, Iraq. Many Kurds objected to this. Ahmed Hoxha was a leading figure in the Kurd independence movement.
وبناوي حكومة عراق عربي عراق تشلمتي كي جوري شمال وزنفر إيمان أمري حق حقوقيك خوان بإيمان بخشيف خوان وإيما زور أمل ما نهبو كسون أما نقول بريطانيا قصتي نهائية وبشمان نابته وكسي لمدي زور كما بشمان
Led by Sheikh Mahmoud, the Kurds rose in rebellion. Just after the end of the Great War, altogether the news of Iraq. The Middle responsible was Winston Churchill. In 1921, he called a Middle East conference in Cairo to discuss the situation. Among those invited, Lawrence of Arabia. The main problem was casualties. After the carnage of the Great War, Churchill was extremely reluctant to risk thousands of British lives in Iraq, a country about which most men. After this crisis came the RAF. Sir Hugh pursued a revolutionary scheme. He proposed sending RAF veterans to crush the rebellion from there. The bombers would be cheap, had difficulties.
Churchill was the air minister at that time, and it was a question whether the country at that time could afford to keep the standing army that we had in Iraq. I think it amounted something like about 13 battalions of infantry. God knows how many battalions of artillery, Air Force, Trenchard, Churchill, that he could take over the responsibility of the country and they could bring them completely out of it and they'll save a lot of money. Because I think there was a great deal of thought in the country that we wanted to get the hell out of it and let the Arabs get on with it.
We were too well bankrupt after the First World War, but we had plenty of aircraft and a lot of keen young supply. So they decided to try, I think, an occupation force, which means a crowd of troops on the ground. They decided to hand over the whole of the running of Iraq to the RAF.
The Air Ministry in London regarded RAF operations in Kurdistan as an excellent training ground. New weapons were developed for use in the air, amongst corners of napalm and air gas. The ministry drew up a list of possible weapons. Phosphorus rockets, metal crow's feet in stock, man-killing shrapnel, liquid fire, and lay-action bombs. Many of these were first put into use by the RAF in Kurdistan.
As soon as they knew we were coming over to bomb, they went up to the hills and sat in their caves. Well, so eventually what they did was to drop delay action bombs so that they'd have a 4-hour delay on a 112-pound bomb. So the natives sort of get off out of the village bombing, eventually return and possibly be put on the actual bench, you see, with them.
In the bombing, the RAF drew little distinction between civilians and combatants. Bombs dropped on a town could kill innocent civilians as easily as rebel tribesmen. Some officers believed by destroying villages and creating refugees on the rebels to take peace. One squadron leader wrote of the tactic, driven from his village, the tribesman is stripped at a blow of all that makes life tolerable. If, to the deprivation of all the necessities of life, is added exposure to war, it will be appreciated air operations conducted in the winter and spring have the maximum moral and physical effect on Kurdish tribes.
Thank you.
In spite of the hardships involved, the Kurds continued their rebellion. The city of Sulaymaniyah, recently one of the centers of the Kurdish uprising against Saddam Hussein, was also the headquarters of its rebellion in the 1920s. Their minister details the conditions in Sulaymaniyah remain unsatisfactory. Sheikh Mahmoud persists in his disobedience of government. People of Sulaymaniyah are notified that as a result, Sulaymaniyah will bomb. Were then sent to drop leaflets over the city. Warned the population the RAF was about, but with no experience of air raids, few people took any notice.
تمنا ولا تعنا ولا أوني أمثيرة. شين بقول أترى وأنا جنك لما أري ساهين شفيع زي ترابو هات ودر وسبرو أخول بري هتا أبو الرحمن بابا بري جي ما خلي جا إما شابا أنا كربا في خاصي كل الله
أبو حميد جا جي لنا جن حاكم أفرتك بومن شاي فارشة شبو دستي أمان بو نی همون لیب بود و دستی آیا کر خاصش اول لاتابو چهارم کرد برادر
شو هر کدوم بچور شو اشون حمامو شو اشون نانی آن کرده آن خواردو و روشی چه گونه که آن ترسا شو اشی آن کرده باهو نترسی تیار.
Like Mohsen, Sheikh Fatalla was staying in Sulaymaniyah. The morning, he was surprised by a door raid.
من هاتر و من مگه خوامان وقتی کم زنی تاری از یه استای زنکو هات با کلانی مالی مفتی بس آسمان و هات مالی از بگیر ایشم چون دانیشم تار که آوا هات کم بلکه فر و کو خوی تار که کم بلکش آوا هات حیوانی مالی توفق برز بود و قابو کم بلکه چون ناو حیوانه که کشور ناو های کوا یه شان ندی بارو که فری فریا او داری داری مون کوت پشتی منو کوت پشتی منو تری او من یکم زنی با سرما او ات دارو نبود وای با سرما بوم بشر او حتی ساعتی چی پیشو تقریبا قلب اتر تهران که هاتن هوارم کردم بنا و متان رم قدرم که بخا کنازو پاش خریبون لگرما بر پشت سمتم کش امیر